Bonjour, je m'appelle Marlon Kroll. Bienvenue à mon exposition Revelation. The show is called Revelation, and I think it's about the euphoria of understanding. In this case, myself, you know, what motivates me, and then also about understanding my mom and my family. I think it's a show of celebration. I imagine the sculptures as sort of actors, and along with the bird song, feels like they're cheering in a chorus or a fanfare. You know, very much capturing this feeling of growth and renewal, springtime. In the show, I bring together drawings that pretend to be paintings, found objects, and handmade sculptures. Part of my process is that I'm always looking for different ways of articulating or approaching the same idea. In my work, even though I usually work quite abstractly, the goal is still to reference or imply the body of some sort. The rowing machine, for example, I see as a body. I've taken some parts of it off to reveal the inside, and then also it has this mechanism built in that pushes and pulls and dispels air. So it feels like a pump, like a heart, like a pair of lungs. And then of course it has this stature that is like just over human size. I think the ceramic assemblages are almost easier to imagine as bodies. There are these delicately balanced, handmade ceramics stacked, again, as if a spine or something, but then they're sitting on these bar stools. So it's easy to imagine that the two of them are having a conversation of some sort. I've been thinking about the trumpet for a little while as an analog to the body, more specifically to like the voice box, to the lungs. You know, it dispels air, it dispels sound, and it has this shape that feels a little bit human. I'm interested in the egg as a symbol of infinity. The small object, it has such a feeling of potential. I don't know, something about an egg, it feels like a fundamental truth. So the paintings are really drawings. So I start by obsessively sketching. Finally, I'll decide that one sketch is worth transcribing. Point where I put the drawing onto the panel, just in graphite, I have to figure out what the image is. You know, is it a body or is it a building? And then from there, you have a couple rules you can follow to find the color. You know, if it's a body part of some sort, you can find a beige, you can find a red, you can find a purple. Or like, sickly light blues. You start to just dot these little colors all over the canvas until something starts to make sense. A couple of days later, this base drawing is just covered in little dots, and then you start to feel a connection between them. And really what I'm looking for is another moment of eureka or euphoria, where all of a sudden you understand the relationship between the colors, the lines, and what I'm trying to represent, even though it's abstract. So then as I start to fill out the panel, these little dots remain, sort of like scars or blemishes, constellations, little birds. Above the door, there's a painting by my mom. I have it in the show for a couple reasons. I think for me, it's funny to see how much similarity we share. You know, you just compositionally and in color. It's no surprise that her paintings have inspired me, probably the most of any artist. But now that she's dead, I don't have many things from her. But I do have her impact and her paintings. So now I see it more as a magical object. You know, it's like protecting me, it's guiding me, influencing me. And here above the door, it's sort of like that. In Germany, we put horseshoes above the door as a symbol of good luck and of protection. So that's how I imagine that painting, sort of protecting me, the exhibition, the foundry. it feels really special to make this show here. I think it's pretty rare that I can have a studio upstairs, a workshop downstairs, and the gallery in the same building. So I can just come from my studio with random objects, you know, try them out, play around. I think it's a pretty rare situation to be in.